Why are you not working hard? Why are you still in my obstacle course? Why are you not working
hard? Hold on, I got this.
Corporal St. John! Wayne Taylor to Deacon St. John.
Taylor, I hear a bike. Tell me you're not out in the shit tracking down that drug trafficker.
Okay. I won't tell you that. But I am.
Damn it, Taylor, you're gonna get yourself killed.
No, man, no. Hey, I followed a bunch of them up the highway.
Highway 97?
Hey, it was daylight, the weather was clear, I didn't see a single freak. But there was this group of men ended up at the ski lodge. Did you even know there was a ski lodge out here? I didn't know that.
Taylor.
It's a sweet-ass setup, too. If I ever decide to bug out, that is where I'm going. Oh, shit, I gotta run. They're stopping at another camp. Taylor, out.
Taylor. Taylor, god damn it. Stupid kid's gonna get himself killed.
Deacon St. John to Captain Corey. St. John to Corey, come back.
St. John, I've just spoken with the Colonel. He's assigned you to the Research Division.
Captain, Research Division, I'm helping Lieutenant Weaver and Lieutenant Whitaker.
Good. They can use all the help you can offer.
I don't know how much help I'm gonna be, and just sort of their errand boy for now. And actually, that's why I radioed in. Lieutenant Whitaker gave me a requisition form that says yeast.
Yeast? Hold a second. We have patrols making supply runs throughout the region. When they come across anything of potential value, they note it down. Yes. Here. The yeast and other baking supplies were noted in the kitchen area of the Crater Lake Visitor's Center. You know where that is?
Yeah, I could find it.
Good luck, Corporal. Hurry out. This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The feds were whining babies, suckling at the teat of us taxpayers. As they were. You can't underestimate them.
Camp full of squatters. You're the assholes who tried to help.
There's some bunker waiting for the freaks to die off. They didn't save the hungry or their precious constituents. You know the real reason they're in power. They saved the elite, the men and women who played ball. They're sitting underground, probably drinking champagne while they wait. Meanwhile, we're out here dying. Suffering. Also, the feds can hit the damn reset button. They have to count for one thing.
I gotta clear the camp. A bunch of murderers and thieves, and I can't let any of them escape.
But once they emerge to reclaim the world when the freaks are gone, we'll be waiting. Oh, yes, we will. And they'll be sorry they ever came out of hiding. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Ah, Jesus, even all the way down here, I can't get away from goddamn Radio Free Oregon.
Coming.
Something's out there.
Get the bastard and kill them.
Like killing drifters, is that it? How do you like it now?
you now! Drifter, come on out. Give up. We got food, water. You don't have to be like this. No, sir. What you...
Okay, one left. It's clear. Now you know how it feels, being on the other end of it, yeah? Yeah. Yeah. Well, I wonder if they got a bunker around here. I'll bet they do. Scrap. I need this.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Let me tell you, before this shit, we were numb and we were dumb. We were blindly taking in opiates of all kinds, keeping us sedated like fat, happy cows. Candy, television, booze, heroin, and it worked. But now, well, we're feeling the pain. All of it. Every cut. We are wide awake, and we are watching. You see the truth of what I've been saying from the beginning. No one can get anything past us. We're the ones running the show now, and we're doing it a damn sight better than the feds ever did. Take a deep breath, and hold it in. You're free men. No one can take that from you again. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Yeah, I hope I'm feeling the pain. Who fucking isn't? Well, fucking Jesse Williams, rest in peace. There it is. Down the hatch. What do they got here? A map, yes. Crafting, hello.
just need this. Reload. Is it? God damn, that's gotta be close. Another one. Yeah, time to light it up. Nest. Whew. Gotta be right around here. Another nest. Hell. Here's another nest. Let's burn it up. Use this.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Back during the American Revolution, when we were fighting for our freedoms, we gained the beautiful right to keep and bear arms. A right we use to protect ourselves, our families, our property. That is, until the ever-growing federal government got scared of the people they swore to protect. Over the years, they stripped us of every gun right they could, using a few mass shootings as an excuse to curtail the God-given rights of us, American citizens. Gun control. And there went the Second Amendment, ladies and gentlemen. Let me ask you this. When all this shit went down, if every American was packing heat, do you think we'd be in this mess? Hell no. But this is how the feds wanted it. disarming the public was just the first step toward getting rid of us all. So who did those gun laws really protect? Sure as hell wasn't us, the American taxpayers. Someday, we ever dig out of this? I want to take a poll. I bet those who survived were those who had guns. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Okay, Cope, this time you got me. I'll take all the guns I can get my hands on. Ain't no one taking them away. Off. Figures. Fuel. Needed this. That's it. Green lights are good. Great damn it. That's gonna bring them all down on me. At last. I think that's all of them. Okay, let's see what we got in here. Micro recorder. Hello.
Oh no. There's nowhere to go. Nowhere to run,
soldier. Shit, not touch that door.
No way out. No way out. Oh no.
I mean it. We're trying to desert it. God help me.
Another manual injector. Good. Jesus, now that's some dedication to duty. This'll help me keep my eyes open. Bounty.